If you're a sneakerhead, I think it's pretty fair to assume that you probably have more than a few pairs of kicks kicking around in your collection. You probably have some that you don't even remember wearing or buying anymore. But have you ever taken the time to actually think about which sneakers you couldn't live without? The ones that you'd be devastated to lose? The ones that you would really miss? What is going on, people of the internet? Welcome back to the channel. Today is a great day because I finally got a haircut and got rid of that shaggy quarantine look. Hey, if y'all are new here, hey, how's it going? My name is Caitlin. I'm a sneakerhead and an entrepreneur on a mission to help encourage and inspire people to find their passions. We're back with another sneaker video, and today we're talking about the top 5 sneakers I wouldn't be able to live without. One of the things that I absolutely love about sneakers is how easy it is to become attached to your favorite ones. If you're a sneakerhead, you know exactly what I'm talking about. You know your sneakers and you have sentimental value towards some of them. I went to school in a different country for 3 years, and obviously because I love sneakers, I needed to bring some with me. The problem was I had too many to transport all of them. So every year my dad would make me pick 8 or 10 sneakers that I wanted to bring, and I would begrudgingly oblige, and every year it was so difficult to choose. Honestly, this is probably why I bought so many sneakers when I lived in the United States. Because I didn't have access to my babies, my complete collection. I had to choose which ones I could bring. Personally, when I think of sneakers that you can't live without, I don't focus on the hype or the limited releases. I focus on the shoes that I wear somewhat regularly. So today, I'm going to be breaking down my top 5 sneakers from my collection that I wouldn't be able to live without. To kick off the list, we're going to begin with one of my favorite sneakers in my entire collection, my Air Jordan 1.5 The Return in the Chicago colorway. Just a side note here, I do personally classify these as Air Jordan 1s in my collection, just because they're such close cousins. The Air Jordan 1 is one of the most recognizable silhouettes out there and has such a rich history, which is why I suggest everyone needs at least one pair in their collection. I honestly love these shoes. I know they're not true Jordan 1 Chicagos, but they're pretty dang close, and I was able to score them for about 70 bucks, which makes them even better in my opinion. The Jordan 1s are my absolute favorite shoe, and this is by far my most worn colorway that I have, and I just love the fact that it's a real head-turner. Because of the Chicago vibes, people immediately think of Michael Jordan and think you're wearing something really dope. Not to mention, as far as Jordan 1s go, this shoe is actually really comfortable. The 1.5 hybrid style came out when Nike was tinkering with different ideas to help give Michael Jordan a comfier or more cushiony shoe, so they decided to mix the beloved Jordan 1 with the sole of a Jordan 2. This is a shoe that I have found I can wear regularly and have it still stand up to the test of time. If you look at it, it's getting pretty banged up. Honestly, if you're looking for an Air Jordan 1 with similar vibes to the Chicago, then definitely take a look at the 1.5s. It's a really solid shoe. Of course, when I eventually do pick up the Air Jordan 1 Breads, then that will definitely hold the top spot in my collection and thus be the sneaker that I can't live without, but for now, it's these bad boys. For sneaker number 2, we're sticking with the Jordan brand and highlighting another favorite in my collection, the Jordan 11 Win Like 96s. Unlike the previous sneaker, this bad boy doesn't carry as much hype and recognition in the sneaker world, but is hands down a must-have shoe in my collection. I love the color red, and the shiny tint on these shoes really make it stand out. It's another sneaker I managed to get on a real nice deal, picking it up for only 60 bucks as a birthday present to myself 2 years ago. Personally, I just feel like this shoe was made perfectly for me. It's my favorite color, it's really comfortable, and it looks extremely dope when you wear it on foot. I feel like it's a really sexy shoe overall. They got the red perfectly right, and it really helps it pop and stand out. This is a shoe that I had been hunting for a long time. I missed out on it when it first dropped because I wasn't too sure. Then when I saw people rocking it on foot, I was like, oh my gosh, I need that in my collection. It's such a beautiful, dope, sexy looking shoe. They didn't overkill it with the red, just enough to make it pop. As you can tell, mine are worn quite a bit, but they still look hella fresh, and it's hands down one of my shoes that I love in my collection and one that I could not live without. Alright, I'm done gushing. This is definitely a shoe that I personally could not do without from my collection. We're gonna switch gears here for the third shoe that I couldn't live without, and honestly, I was a little bit torn on this one. I absolutely need a nice athletic running shoe in my everyday rotation that supports my foot, is comfortable, and looks solid. I usually turn to Adidas for this type of shoe, and all throughout 2019, I was really hype on the Ultra Boost, and I still love it. But since picking up the NMDs from Adidas, I haven't worn my Ultra Boost nearly as much. In fact, I don't actually remember the last time I rocked them. The NMDs look better than the Ultra Boost in my personal opinion, and I found them to be much comfier when I've had to be on my feet all day. As an entrepreneur who just launched, I do a lot of work at trade shows, and I found my NMDs to be the perfect companion for a long day of being on your feet. Now, they might not have as much added cushioning and support as the Ultra Boost, but I think that's what actually makes me like them even more. They feel more natural and loose on your feet, giving your feet more space to breathe. I have relatively wide and flat feet, so I had enough room to even throw in some orthotics in there, and they still fit with lots of room to spare, which is super helpful. So for this one, I'm giving the edge to the Adidas NMDs in, well, you guessed it, the colorway red. This is a shoe that I know I can rock on the regular. It's gonna be comfy, it's gonna be there for support, it looks dope, it's my favorite color, just a really overall nicely designed shoe from Adidas in my personal opinion. Like I said, I like the aesthetic and the looks better than the Ultra Boost. And yeah, the comfort is just really what wins me over here. I know it's a shoe that I could put lots of miles into, and I'm not going to have to worry about it holding up, and my feet aren't going to be sore at the end of the day. So it looks nice, it does the job, it supports my feet. It's a winner. Sneaker number 4 is going to take us back to the Nike side of the sneaker world with the Air Max 90s. The 90s are an instant classic in any person's collection and just an overall really dope shoe. Unless you get an off-white collab, they're not too flashy, but they hold their own with the beautiful design and Nike history. They're not overly expensive, and it's a shoe that you don't feel bad putting some serious miles into. My last year of school, I had a black and blue pair of Air Max 90s that were my daily beaters that I wore everywhere. I wore these to the gym, in bad weather, traveling, you name it, they were my instant go-to, and they were pretty comfy. I love the fact that the 90s feature a little bit more of a chunky bottom, which in my opinion gives the shoe a little more support and strengthens its durability. There are so many dope colorways out there with the Air Max 90s. I currently have 2, and I did have a 3rd before I sold it, but I'm sticking with the neon green as my shoe that I can't live without from the Air Max 90s category. I love these shoes. Like I mentioned, they do have a little bit of a chunkier bottom because they have that air pocket thing that they have to protect there, but I like the fact that they don't really cross over into dad shoes. They're still a dope Nike sneaker that really anyone can rock. You don't have to worry about them. They're sleek, they're cool, they're comfortable, and they're just an instant classic in anyone's rotation. When you rock them, they look dope and people immediately think you're a sneakerhead. You got great taste in shoes. So the Air Max 90s are 100%, especially in the neon gray, a shoe that I could not live without. For the 5th and final shoe on this list, I had a really, really difficult time narrowing it down. Hey, I get sentimental about my sneakers. What do you want? There's so many avenues you can choose from. I love my 77 Nike Blazers. They're an absolute must cop. And I love my Vans Old School, both the high top and the low top. But I'm not sure either of those sneakers are ones I would put on a list like this. It's just way too much pressure. Like if I was leaving tomorrow and I could only take 5 sneakers with me, I have to make sure it's 5 pairs of bangers that I would absolutely wear on the regular. So I think I have to give the nod from the 5th and final spot to the Nike Air Vapor Max 97s, which are pretty much the silent sleeper in my collection. I love the colorway of the shoe. I think it's super versatile and it looks good with so many different fits. And I love what Nike did combining the Air Max technology in a new way to form a totally unique and fairly comfortable shoe. This is definitely a shoe that I think a lot of people sleep on, but I would be pretty gutted if I didn't have it in my rotation to rock on the regular. I feel like the Air Vapor Max 97 is like the perfect hybrid mix between a somewhat hype sneaker and an everyday sneaker that you don't feel bad about putting miles into. It looks dope with so many fits, like I mentioned, especially if you're rocking it with jeans. Such a nice, dope, sleek shoe. It's got the air bubbles on the bottom, so it does kind of make it feel like you're walking on a cloud, which is awesome. And like I said, it's a shoe I'm not afraid to put some miles in, which would be awesome because I want to save some of my other sneakers. So this definitely makes the list and rounds out my 5 sneakers that I could not live without. Well, that pretty much wraps up my list of 5 sneakers that I couldn't live without. I did my best to pick versatile shoes that can be rocked with multiple fits and ones that let people know you're into sneakers. A few of these are definitely some of the favorites in my collection, and definitely shoes that I'm not leaving home without anytime soon. What did you guys think of my list? What would your list of 5 sneakers that you couldn't live without include? Let me know down in the comments below. I would love to read about your lists. Thank you guys so much for taking the time to watch today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, hit that like button, and then hit that subscribe button to join the family. And as always, I'll catch you guys in the next video.